Hi everybody, Karen Fabian here, founder of Bare Bones Yoga, and thanks for watching this video. I'm glad that you are here. So what I wanted to do today is go over a little bit about how you build a sequence with an anatomy theme in mind. And of course, this entire task of building a sequence with anatomy in mind and a theme of anatomy in mind has to be predicated on you having a really good understanding of anatomy. And this is oftentimes where teachers fall short. They start at the end game without doing all of the preliminary steps before. And so imagine not having a good handle on anatomy and going in to teach a class and teaching people poses and using different kinds of cues and not really being sure of what the anatomy themes are. Well, this is exactly what happens when, before you build that knowledge of anatomy, you go into the end game of creating the sequence. One of the things that I really enjoy doing is walking teachers through the different steps of learning anatomy. And one of the things that's a hallmark of my signature program, the Blueprint Learning Program, is I don't get into things like cueing and sequence building until teachers have built a really good understanding of the key concepts that need to be understood before you get to that higher level task. So today I'm going to kind of assume that you have that knowledge, or maybe this will be an opportunity for you to hear some things you're unfamiliar with and then to go out and fill in the learning gaps. And I think that's a great way to be inspired to go out and get some specific learning around a particular topic. So let's say you wanted to go into a class and you wanted to have a theme of backbending. So we're going to go to the skeleton here because this is where your preliminary thought process around building a sequence with backbending in mind has to be coming from having a good understanding of what do you need to have in order to do healthy backbends. Well, when we're doing backbends, we're moving the spine into extension, which is the opposite of flexion. So if you're a little unsure already, think of spinal flexion, which is this, and the opposite is this. So it's the movement in the sagittal plane, taking a body part generally backwards. And so if we're going to be doing a lot of spinal extension, we are going to be using muscles in the back of the body, right? The muscles we use to flex are going to be in the front of the body. So as I flex my spine, I'm using my rectus abdominis. As I flex my hip, I'm using my psoas, right? So here I'm extending my spine. So I'm using muscles on the back of the body. So which muscles am I using? Well, I'm using the spinal extensor muscles. That makes sense. Otherwise known as the erector spinae. And this is a series of muscles that runs parallel to the spine. There are three different sections of the erector spinae. Let's just say for purposes of this conversation, we'll call it, and it's definitely called, one group of muscles that can help us stay erect, or if we contract them more, they can allow us to move into spinal extension. So that's one of them. Now, another muscle of extension is going to be the gluteus maximus, which is the back of the hip. And then another muscle of hip extension is the hamstrings. And so you may think of the hamstrings as the muscle that bends your knee. It's got a dual function because it also extends your hip because of its origin on the ischial tuberosities, aka the sitting bones. And you can also think of gluteus maximus and the hamstring complex acting as synergists as they together function to create that hip extension. So now we know we're going to go into a sequence, into class, we're going to build a sequence for this class that focuses on backbending. Now we know the muscles that we need to strengthen. And so if we know the muscles we need to strengthen, now we can look at the opposing muscles and think about things to offer students that would help them lengthen those muscles. And if you're already a little bit confused, let's just focus on one particular part of the body and that should help you understand it. So if we want to go into a backbend,
I already said we're going to be using the erector spinae to create that spinal extension. And then we said we're going to be using gluteus maximus to create that hip extension. Well, what's the opposing muscle to gluteus maximus? I mentioned it earlier. The psoas, starting from the lumbar spine running to the femur. So this muscle needs to be lengthened in order for this muscle to take our hip into extension. So now you can begin to see, and you can use that same paradigm for the shoulder. If I'm going to be moving into spinal extension, I need the external rotators of my shoulders to be strong. Those are muscles that live on the posterior aspect of the shoulder, teres minor and infraspinatus, and I need the muscles that are the antagonists to those muscles, pec minor, pec major, coracobrachialis, subscapularis, I need all of those muscles to have a good amount of mobility so they allow me to open the shoulders. So now I hope you begin to see how the body is working in this synergistic way, ideally, to allow people to go into these back bends, whether it's something like upward facing dog, where I'm using those back body muscles to create the back bend, or whether it's something like camel pose, again, using muscles in the back, lengthening muscles in the front, or whether I'm coming down into bridge pose, using muscles in the back, lengthening muscles in the front, or of course, coming into a full back bend wheel. So, now you have an idea of the anatomy involved in the back bends, what needs to be strengthened, what needs to be lengthened. So now you can begin to create the poses that will essentially allow for that strength to appear, right? Create the scenarios where you can lengthen these muscles so that when you get in your sequence to your back bends, the body is primed for it. Now, you've probably heard of the concept of the peak pose. You could certainly work people to a peak posture, a back bend of some kind, wheel or camel, that kind of thing. Or you can think of it as the general goal of this practice is back bending. And as I take people through a series of graduated steps, they're going to be I'm going to be focusing them on strengthening here and lengthening here. And there's certainly a lot of poses that fit the bill. The poses I showed you are back bends. We could certainly add in some strengthening for those hip flexors, so different kinds of lunges that also have a lengthening component as well. Because remember, as I come into a lunge, I'm flexing this hip, I'm extending this hip. When I do the opposing side, it's the opposite effect. So lunges, whether Warrior One, Warrior Two, crescent lunge, these are all really good for working both sides in opposing ways. So I hope this has been helpful for you. What I would love for you to be able to take away from this is an understanding of how you build a sequence with an anatomy theme. And if you're looking for a little bit more structure around how to do this, which is totally understandable, go to my website right on the homepage, and I'll actually include it here as a link, is my sequence building template. And that walks you through this process in a generic way so you can use the template over and over again to help you build sequences that focus on whatever themes you want to focus on. So thank you so much for watching this. I hope to see you in the next video. Don't forget to click the like button if you liked this video and the subscribe button so you don't miss the next one. Namaste.